Wow, what a mess. Looks like somebody had a party here. I wonder if it was Mr. G and Mr. Lab Rat. What have you guys been doing here?
Pastor Carl, Lab Rat, why didn't you say anything? We thought you're here. We thought you were on vacation.
No, it's a new year. It's time for us to film the first episode of Kids Church TV this year. What happened to the studio, guys?
Lab Rat did it. He did
Lab Rat.
He invited all of his furry little friends and these like four different colored turtles.
Weird.
And it was quite strange. And now I'm here to clean up Lab Rat's mess.
Lab Rat, what do you have to say for yourself, hmm? What's that? Mr. G? He had friends over too? And they were playing pin the tail on the Lab Rat. Mr. G, that's not very nice.
I'm sorry, Lab Rat.
Sorry, and you guys didn't clean up your mess.
Oh, and I'm sorry, we didn't even invite you.
You didn't invite me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Like, that makes me sad.
Please forgive us. Right, Lab Rat?
I do. I forgive you.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Well, you're going to clean this mess up?
Yeah, I'll clean it up.
All right. And we're going to start Kids Church TV?
Okay, let's start.
All right. Yeah. Hey, kids, I'm Pastor Carl. That's Mr. G. That's Lab Rat. Welcome to Kids Church TV. Hey, boys and girls, and welcome to another great day here on Kids Church TV. And not just a great day, it's another great year. Happy New Year. We're so excited that you're joining with us today. We haven't seen you since last year. Wow, totally thought Mr. G was there just now. Wow. Well, we're really excited to learn what God has to teach us today in God's big story. Whoa, I thought Mr. G was there again, but I didn't see him. Boys and girls, have you seen Mr. G today? Maybe I'm just imagining things, but I thought he was in here somewhere. Okay, well, moving on.
Hey, Pastor Carl.
Whoa! Oh, my goodness, hey. Mr. G. Yeah. Oh, man, I couldn't see you, but I just knew you were close by. Oh. I thought you were here, and then I thought you were there, and then I thought you were out there, and I just, man.
Really?
Wait
a second. Are you saying that you know where I am and what I'm doing all the time?
Well, I think maybe it's just because we're always together here on Kids Church TV, and you're kind of like always right there beside me. I've just gotten so used to it that I just thought that you were always around.
Okay, yeah, I see.
All right, enough dilly-dallying. Let's go over to our studio and review our big idea and memory verse today. How's that sound?
Oh, like warm apple pie on a Sunday morning.
What does that even mean?
Let's go, come on.
All right, let's go. Okay, here we go. Spread some sprinkles on your ice cream. Our big idea for today, boys and girls, drum roll, God is with us.
Oh, wow. Wait a second.
Yeah.
I'm wondering something.
Yeah?
I wonder if the boys and girls have ever felt nervous about something before.
Ooh, maybe like nervous. On the first day at a new school?
Yeah.
Or maybe the first day of a new school year with different classmates and different classroom and different teachers.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's exactly what I'm thinking. Now, maybe they didn't know where to go.
Yeah.
Or maybe they didn't know who to talk to.
Right.
Or maybe they didn't even know where to eat lunch.
Even in those times when you're maybe a bit nervous, guess what? God is with you. God is with us.
Wow, that's so amazing.
Yeah.
Our memory verse today is hopefully going to help you boys and girls remember this.
For sure.
Now, it's a new memory verse, and it's from the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 20, verse 4. So listen to what it says. For the Lord your God is he who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies, to give you the victory.
Wow. Did you catch that, boys and girls? That verse tells us that God goes with us wherever we go. How cool is that?
Yeah, it's so cool. Wait a second.
Yeah, God is that amazing.
Does that mean that God is with me when I go to work?
Yes, he is.
Well, what about when I go to my friend's house?
He's with you.
Okay, but is he with me when I go to sleep?
Yep.
And what about if I'm like sad or scared?
He's with you.
Wow. God really is so amazing.
Yeah, he is amazing. And he is always with us. So right now, boys and girls, wherever you are, why don't you stand up with us as we're going to worship and sing our great God, because he is with us. Go ahead. Stand up. Let's sing.
Let's go.
So mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. He made the trees, he made the seas, he made the elephants too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. So strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the valleys are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Welcome! You've come just in time. I'm playing with some really fun science. I'm Sophia the scientist, self-taught, and this is my assistant lab rat. Oh, hi again. Aren't you excited? Guess what, lab rat? I've got a magic trick to show you. Are you ready? What's that? No, I'm not gonna make you disappear. But first, safety. I got my lab coat, check. Lab glasses, check. And my lab rat, checkity check. Okay, just watch. See? I'm moving it, but I'm not touching it. See? I'm not even touching the paper clips. It's like magic. Okay. It's not really magic. It's science with magnets. Even though you couldn't see the magnet, I was using it to move this paper clip around and around. It just looked like I was moving it without touching it. Magnets are so cool. They get stuck to one another, and sometimes they're really hard to pull apart. What's that, lab rat? What do you mean, what does this have to do with God's big story today? Okay, pay attention now, or I'll tell your Uncle Shredder that you've been being lazy, lab rat. People, like me and the boys and girls watching, naturally like to run away from God. We do this whenever we sin. Every time we disobey God, it's like we're running away from him. But God always comes after us. He's with us, and even when we sin, he pulls us back to him with his love. Kind of like what magnets do. No matter what, God always loves us and will always be with us. You just gotta love science. It helps us see how amazing God is. What's that, lab rat? You want me to put magnets on the two of us so we'll never be apart? I don't think that's a good idea. Okay, boys and girls, see you next time. Bye. Lab rat, say bye.
Hi, boys and girls, and welcome to our Bible teaching for today. This week on Kids Church TV, we're learning about what it means that God is with me. Can you say that? Can you say God is with me? I can't hear you. I still can't hear you. Okay, I think I heard you. You said God is with me. Now, near the beginning of God's big story, God freed his people from slavery and brought them into the wilderness. God was leading them to a place called the Promised Land. So wherever God would go, the Israelites would go with him.
Okay, this way, guys. God is saying the Promised Land is this way. All right, let's go.
This was going to be a place where the Israelites could live in freedom. While they were in the wilderness, the Israelites followed God.
All right, God is moving his people. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
God was with them the whole way, and he chose a very special way to lead his people. Look at this. Look at this, boys and girls. During the day, God led his people with a huge cloud. And at night, he led them with a pillar of fire. Wherever the cloud or the fire went, the Israelites followed. And when it stopped, they set up camp. Boys and girls, imagine what it would be like to follow clouds around or to follow fire around. Now, for years, the Israelites followed God through the desert. Now, what do you think the desert was like? Do you think it was hot? Or maybe it was cold? Well, obviously it was hot. It's a desert. Now, they had to depend on God every step of the way. They had to trust God to show them where to go, to give them shelter to live, and even to give them food. But, boys and girls, again, God was with them. God provided food for the Israelites every day through something called manna. Can you say manna? Well, look at this. Manna rained from heaven each and every single morning. The manna was very yummy. It was a miracle. After a while, the Israelites got tired of manna and they started complaining. They wanted different food. What do you think it would be like to eat the same food every day? Imagine eating like broccoli every single day. Or even eating like chocolate cake every single day. Don't eat chocolate cake every single day. That's bad. But what do you think it would be like to eat the same thing every single day? Well, boys and girls, how do you think God felt about the Israelites complaining? He had given them food and now they're complaining. Well, God was upset. He was very sad. He had been taking care of them the whole time and he was with them every step of the way. God deserved their trust. But even so, the Israelites didn't like the desert and they only wanted to complain. They're probably very grumpy. But because God is loving, boys and girls, he took care of them even though they were complaining. During this time, God told Moses to send some men to look at a land called Canaan. They were supposed to go into the land and see what was there. This was part of the promised land that they were going towards. Now, a leader from each of the 12 tribes went to check out the land and report back. They were going to come back and tell everyone what they had found. Now, when the men returned, they said that the land was flowing with milk and honey. So that meant there was plenty of food to eat. But there was one problem. And they told him, "We came to the land to which you sent us. It flows with milk and honey, and this is its fruit. However, the people who dwell in the land are strong, and the cities are fortified and very large." Boys and girls, did you hear that? They were scared of the really big people in the land. These people were much bigger and much tougher than the little Israelites. Well, they weren't really that little, but they were small compared to those people. Now, one of the Israelite leaders, his name was Caleb, and he said that they should go in and take the land because God would be with them. But other men who went with them were afraid. They were afraid of the big men who lived there. And they said this. They said, "We seem like grasshoppers to them." They thought they were like little grasshoppers to these big, big people. Now these men began to spread rumors to the Israelites that the land God had promised them was too scary to enter. They went and told everyone in the camp, "It's too scary, we can't go there." Now, boys and girls, how do you think the Israelites responded to hearing that this land was too scary? Yeah, they complained again.
"Are you kidding me? The people are how tall? Wow, I don't want to fight them. Thanks, I'll just stay here and collect some firewood."
But Joshua, another one of those who had gone in to look at the land of Canaan, he also said that the Lord would give them the land. But they still chose not to trust God. Boys and girls, God deserved the trust of the Israelites. They could count on God because he was with them. He had given them everything. He had freed them from slavery in Egypt. He had parted the Red Sea so they could walk through it. And he provided food and protection for them every single day. He was leading them to a beautiful place to call home. They were going to go to this new beautiful home. And even though he knew it was difficult for the people to live in the desert, God was still with them. He was helping them. The Israelites could trust him. Because God's people didn't trust him, they were not allowed to go into the promised land. They weren't able to see the promised land. God said that only their children could go into the promised land. Now, boys and girls, in this part of God's big story, we can see how the Israelites were scared. And because they were scared, that kept them from trusting that God was with them, even though he had been with them the whole time. Trusting in God is also hard for us to do. It's hard for me to do sometimes. Is it hard for you to trust God sometimes? But God asks us to trust him, and he says that he will be with us too. He knows what is best for us. And when we choose to trust in God, boys and girls, he helps us to see that he really is with us wherever we go. So boys and girls, wherever you are right now, why don't you stand up with me? Come on, stand up right now. And let's sing to our wonderful, amazing God who is with us.
For you, I clap and lift my hands. Oh God, for you, I sing and dance.
To call Miss You Muffins. You see, now, Miss Ma'am's mama, well, her name was Mama Ma'am, she used to make these wonderfully warm and gooey muffins. Oh, well, they tasted so sweet. Well, they were sweeter than that time I covered my marshmallows with maple syrup before I put them in the campfire. Oh, mercy, that was a sugar rush for days. Oh, well, now, Mama Ma'am had her own secret ingredient for her muffins, molasses. Well, Before my mom man passed away, well, she perfected her recipe and gave it to me to make for my family. Now, every time I make this muffin recipe, well, I just feel like my mama is still here with me. And, you know, they also remind me that even when I feel sad, well, I know that God is with me. He's helping me. He's giving me joy and happiness because I know that He loves me. Well, I miss my mama, and my kidlets sure miss their mama. But, you know, even when we miss someone, or even when we're sad, or even when we're scared, you know, God is with us. Always remember that, y'all. I don't want you ever to forget. Say it to yourself every day. God is with me. Well, all right, y'all come back next time because Miss Ma'am is going to work with a new exotic ingredient that she just found out about. It's called cream cheese. All right, bye for now, y'all.
I wonder what it would be like to eat the same thing every day. I mean, I think I'd be fine with it. I mean, maybe it's not this bread. Maybe it's chips. Whoa, yeah, maybe it's chips.
I think even if you ate chips every day, you'd eventually get tired of them and complain that you wanted something else, just like those Israelites from our Bible teaching today.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Oh, well. Pastor Carl, let's get to our questions for today. And maybe you can let us know what one question you're kind of excited about.
Yes, I'm excited for you boys and girls to talk about question number 3. How is God with you? And how has He been with you? We know that He's with us all the time, but what does that mean? Have you been learning about that? And have you experienced that before? How is that truth encouraged you before? I'm excited for you boys and girls to talk about that and more with someone in your classroom or in your home as soon as we're done here today.
Wow, what a wonderful way to start the new year with God's word and with a great reminder that God is with us.
And even when we don't think it, God is there to help us. When we're sad, when we're angry, when we're scared or nervous, God is with us.
I don't know about you, Pastor Carl, but I'm pretty excited for our first rewind of the year.
I know you are, and I'm really excited about our rewind. As some of you boys and girls already know, a rewind is where we kind of rewind through the episode to look at some of the highlights and important things we've learned from today. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
Let's rewind.
And even though He knew it was difficult for the people to live in the desert, God was still with them. For the Lord your God is He who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies, to give you the victory.
Drum roll. God is with us.
And that's our rewind for today, boys and girls. But before we say bye for today, why don't you pray for us, Pastor Carl, and thank God for our time together.
Absolutely, boys and girls. Let's pray together. God and Heavenly Father, we thank You that You love us and You are always with us, that we don't have to worry about being alone, that You're not near us, but You are. You are always with us and You love us and You care for us. Thank You, Lord, for being with us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. All right, boys and girls, that's all the time we have for today.
We're so thankful that you were able to be with us and learn about how God is with us.
And until we see you again, remember that God loves you.
See you all soon. Bye for now.